There are three things you can use to convince viewers to click on your video: the title, the description, and the thumbnail. I'm Brighton West, and today on Subscriber Nation, I'll show you how to create a custom thumbnail using free software. So in order to be able to create a custom thumbnail, you're going to need some kind of video editing software. So you might have Photoshop already on your machine, or you could use something like Pixlr Editor, or PicFont is a really simple software, but you can't do a lot of editing. My tool of choice is GIMP, and it is free. You can download that for a Mac or a PC or Unix. You've kind of got a lot of options here. It is open source software. So we're gonna start using GIMP here, and I'll explain to you how to set up your custom thumbnail. So once you've got your software installed on your computer, or if you're using PicFont or Pixlr, that actually runs in your browser, you'll start by opening up the image that you're going to create the thumbnail from. Now, what I suggest is that while you're taking your video, you actually shoot a couple of still images so that you're smiling and you're looking at the camera and you've got kind of the white space on the correct side, or the open space on the correct side of you where you're gonna put your text. So really be thinking about the thumbnail while taking those pictures. If you haven't done that, you can always go through your editing software and try to grab a still image out. It just is a little trickier trying to find one where you don't look funny, kind of in between words. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm in GIMP now, and I am going to open up that image. So this was the image that I took earlier while I was shooting the video. And the first thing I'm going to do is I need to resize the image. So I want to use this same aspect ratio, which is 16 wide by 9 high. And so I just start by kind of estimating. If this image was perfect, I would just start putting text on top of it. But it's got a little extra space above my head there. So I'm going to just draw a box around what I want the final image to look like and try to make it that 16 wide by 9 tall aspect ratio. So you don't have to be perfect, and you'll come up to Image and Crop to Selection. And the next thing you'll do is Image Scale Image. So this is where you want to get it approximately the right size. And the image size we're shooting for is 1280 by 720. So I start typing in 1280 and then hit Tab. And you'll see the height here would be just 666. So that's not tall enough. So what you want to do is get the one of these numbers where the other one is bigger. So the height of 720 gives us a width of 1383. We'll chop that off in the next step. So scale. We've rescaled our image. And the next thing you want to do is resize the canvas size. So you can see very similar box here. And this time this little chain link is broken, which means that if I change the top one, the bottom one's not going to change. And I change the top to 1280 and hit Tab. And now you can see here that it's going to cut off the sides of the image. So you can kind of move the image back and forth and get it to the spot that you want it to be. That looks about good. And then hit Resize. And the reason you don't do this with the image size or scale image is you'd be changing the proportions and kind of making yourself, you know, really fat or really skinny as you're changing the proportions. So you have to use the canvas size. Take those two steps. Okay, now the next thing I want to do is add this layer, and this template is going to be available down in the show notes and on my website for you to download. So this is just to kind of keep you out of the areas where YouTube is going to put some text over your thumbnail. So go ahead and open as layer. So download that file, then open as layer, and it's called thumbnail safe area. And now you can see kind of the area where YouTube is going to put text, and the mobile safe area is actually a little bit, you know, even smaller than the desktop safe area, which is out here. And this is that play button that pops up every once in a while. You just don't want that to be like right on someone's nose or over a key graphic element. So the next thing you'll do is you'll insert some text, just coming over and using the text tool and There you go. You can type some text and just make sure that you're getting a decent size here. So somewhere around 100, around 100 is a good size. So this is a test. And of course that 100 didn't stick. Let me highlight it, put that 100 back in. You can see kind of the area there that it's taking up. Can come over to this dialog box to determine if you want it left justified or red right justified or what color you want it. So I'm just going to leave it like that. And you can see it's created another layer up here for the text. And like I said, if you have it down here, text is going to be underneath the numbers on a computer. If you have it up here, it's going to be beneath the numbers on a mobile device. So just get it in this area, and this is a test that works. You can also insert any other graphics or things that you want to have on your thumbnail on a regular basis. I encourage you to kind of have some graphic theme that goes along with your thumbnail. I'm not going to put that in at this point. So then come over to the layer box and push on the little eyeball next to the thumbnail safe template. And you've got what your thumbnail is going to look like. Last, go up to File, and then say or Export As, and you'll export to a JPEG file. So I'm going to call this my thumbnail tutorial thumbnail. And click Export. And you'll choose a quality. You can choose the defaults here. Okay, now the last thing to do is you've got your custom thumbnail. Let's upload it to YouTube. So you'll see here on your YouTube page for your info and settings, you'll see a custom thumbnail button here underneath the thumbnails that YouTube has chosen randomly. If you don't see this, you can click on another one of my tutorials about how to get this button. But for now, let's assume that you have this button all set up. Just click it. Upload your thumbnail, and you will have the option of having a custom thumbnail for your video.
I hope that helps you attract more viewers to your videos. If you have any questions, be sure to leave those in the comment section down below, and be sure to click the subscribe button. I bring you videos just like this for online creators every week.
So I just wanted to show you a really quick method to get text onto pictures. If you've already got a picture that's the right size and you like it and you're just ready to add the text to create your thumbnail, head over to picfont.com and it says add text to picture in 10 seconds, which is true. Let's go over and we're just going to pull in the image that is properly sized, drop it onto PicFont. It pulls up and we can just start adding text to this. So I'm going to say custom thumbnail, custom. You can see here it should show up. You can change the size of it. You want it to be nice and big and a font that you can see clearly. You might want to change the style and throw an outline around the outside of it. But I'm actually just going to move it right on over here. And then click here to create another block of text, thumbnail. And let that show up. Move that over. And move these guys around, get them in the perfect location. There you have your custom thumbnail. Just head on over and click Save. It will download it, and you'll be able to upload that to YouTube.